We hope everybody is safe and sound during quarantine mode. We welcome you back to GoSycamores.com. It's great to see this smiling face. Haven't seen him in a while. It's been almost a month, to be quite honest. It's head coach Greg Lansing. As today is National Signing Day. We'll get to his three signees here in just a moment. But coach, number one, just how are you doing? How's the family doing, mom and dad and Christy and everybody? Everybody safe and sound and healthy?
Yeah, everybody's great. We came down to Scottsdale, Christy and I, about 3 weeks ago. Just been enjoying the weather, for one. It's been a little down here. You can get outside and take nice walks and hikes, and we're doing that every day. Mom and dad are fine. They're quarantined in Des Moines, as well as my sister and my brother and his family. So everybody seems to be doing good and handling it the best that they can. You get a little stir crazy, as everybody is, but have to understand how fortunate we are to be in the situation we are, and just pray for anybody that's affected and everybody with their physical and mental health, because we'll get through all this.
I'm sure it's been part of your message to your guys. You have Zoom meetings with them so you can actually see them and communicate with them, even though it's not in-person communication. What's been your message really to them during this time of just, as you mentioned, there's just so much uncertainty?
Well, the great thing is, I first got down here, we got three commits that we're going to talk about here in a little bit, but the staff did an unbelievable job. That's how good they are. We got to fill the needs that we had as a team, and we really feel like we got a chance to have a good team, and so we're excited about that. And like you said, we've been doing Zoom chats twice a week. Also, we're calling them individually. I update them on what we're doing every day and just kind of responses back and forth, whether it be by text messages or phone calls. And we're staying in touch, the staff, we're in touch every day, all day, and just making sure all those guys are doing well. But, it's a different time. It's strange, and it's strange for everybody. And what we've tried to do is just go through on the Zoom calls, like just some exercises, what's the best thing that's happened? What's the worst thing that's happened? Your goals for the year, what are you working on? Where are you working out? Doing some fun stuff on our Zoom chats and getting the guys all together so they can crack on each other and crack on us and having fun again. So I think everybody seems to be doing pretty well, and we'll just see how long this takes moving forward.
Okay, well, let's talk about the positivity today here on Signing Day. You welcome in three new guys into your program. We'll begin with T.J. Howard, Tobias Howard, Jr. Why was he somebody that you wanted to go after and ultimately put in a Sycamore uniform?
Well, you lose Jordan Barnes. Jordan, J.B., was a heck of a player. You've seen all the stats and where he ranks. One of the best to ever played Indiana State, had a great impact, was really – happy for him and our team, but more importantly, him individually, for his leadership this year, getting us back to where we belong up there near the top. So getting TJ was very, very important to us. He's a proven quantity. I mean, he scored in a good league against good basketball teams. Have to give TP most of the credit on this one, because he's got a previous relationship. He played for his father back in Atlanta. So TP took the lead and got us going on that, and we jumped on it the best we can. And as you know, Luke, it's not always about accumulating talent. It's about building a team. And that was a big step for us to get a high quality point guard like that.
Randy Miller Jr., another transfer that you're getting to come into your program. How did Randy kind of get on your radar and ultimately get signed?
Kareem Richardson recruited him previously and has a real strong relationship with he and his father. So as soon as we knew we were going to have another scholarship, we got on that. And losing a Christian Williams and a Jordan Barnes and Bronson Kessinger, Randy's a bucket getter, and he's got baskets in big games. He's played in NCAA tournaments. He's another proven quantity, and he's going to fit right in. Another guy that can really shoot it from the three, get his own baskets or create for others. But he and Tobias are both tough dudes, and I like that. I like the fact that they've played at a high level, a competitive level, and are already accomplished.
You brought up how Tobias has played at a really high level. Randy's played at a high level. What can those guys take from their previous stops that can really help your team this year as you get back together with still a lot of young guys that have got more experience and they're continuing to improve, but how their previous experiences can really be a big impact in your team right away?
They've won, Luke. That's the biggest one. They're winners. They've won. They're tough guys. They come from basketball families. They've already done some great things at a high level. Tremendous experience by both of these guys. And one thing I love about both of them is they knew about us. You know, they knew about Tyree Key, Jake Laravia, Trey, Coop, Kobe. You know, they knew about what we had coming back. And for a scorer like Randy, he didn't bat an eye because Tyree Key's coming back. He wants to come in and help us win. And those guys, it's important for fifth-year guys because they have 1 year left. And you've got to come in. You want to win. You can go a lot of different places and have tremendous numbers and maybe better numbers that they're going to have for us, but it's about winning.
Well, the third guy you added is definitely going to help you in the post. What does Nango Indau really bring to your program in terms of course, you look at his physique and you know just his body is going to make a big impact, but what do you like more than just outside of what you see in his frame and the physical side that he brings?
Well, you see that. You know, he walks in the room and you're going to be able to see it. Our fans are going to love his personality, a very infectious personality, a lot of smiling and joking around and having a good time. But the physical tools that he has, he just can't teach. And he's a worker. I know his junior college coach very well. We've gone back. We've had players from when he was previously at Coffeyville. Now being at Butler, that team won. Now, Duongo also had an injury, you know, so he had to sit out quite a bit of the year, but he was very productive before the injury, very productive on a good team after that. And you've watched the highlights and the clips of him. You got a rim protector back there, guy that can run both floors, tremendous defender on ball screens. And I liken him to Miles Walker on our NCAA tournament team. He can do those types of things. We've needed some help for Trey in there. I think Trey, you know, losing Bronson and Bronson not being able to practice as much and play the minutes as all of us would have liked to, this guy's got a bundle of energy and he's going to really help to where Trey doesn't have to get every rep and every practice and every game. And you combine him in there with Nick Hiddle coming in, and I think that'll be a great three-headed monster.
Coach, I don't want to make this and say this is an issue because of everything else that's going on in the world right now, but knowing that the summertime right now is not going to be the typical summer that you normally have. So for specifically these guys that you have that you want to integrate with your current guys, what are ways that you're trying to get them integrated and get them involved, yet even though on the court they may not be able to build that chemistry for a time period that we just all don't know yet?
Well, I look at it like this. You get such good guys, and our freshman class of last year, Jake, Trey, and Kobe, and Jared, and Keon, they're just made of the right stuff. I mean, it wasn't after we got all these guys committed, Jake Laravia's texting me, calling me, wanting all their numbers to get them on group Snapchats or out chats or group texts or whatever they're doing. So they're doing that on their own. Those guys are doing that on their own, and then being able to do Zoom chats, getting together. They have to stay active, you know, even in these difficult times. They have nothing can be required. We can't do anything. It's like, here's what we're doing. Ken has given them some options of what they can do if they have weights or don't have weights, trying to get a ball in their hand and doing those things. But I give our guys a lot of credit. They're doing a lot of this on their own and staying connected.
Well, Coach, I appreciate you being able to suspend some of your hiking to talk about your signing day class today. How many miles have you done?
We're over 110 in a couple of weeks and over 500 floors, and it's just beautiful. We've been up and down and around six mountains, and it's just a great place to get outside and still doing your social distancing, but it's a good place to spend your quarantine time.
Coach, really can't wait to meet these three guys, but most of all, just can't wait till I can walk into your office and say good morning to you again. Appreciate the time, buddy. Continue to stay safe, and we'll talk again soon.
Can't wait, Luke. Looking forward to it, and to all our coaches and Sycamores out there, everybody stay safe, stay positive, because we'll get through this. It's going to be a great year to be a Sycamore.